Hillsong founder Brian Houston has been cleared of covering up the crimes of his paedophile father to protect the global church. Frank Houston confessed to his crimes but died without being charged. And today, one of his victims described the life sentence he has endured.
Exonerated over the sins of his paedophile father. But Brian Houston could not ignore the painful past.
A lot of people's lives have been tragically hurt, and for that I'll always be very sad. But I'm not my father.
The man who created Hillsong found not guilty of concealing the abuse of Brett Sengstock, just 7 years old, when he was raped by Pentecostal pastor Frank Houston in the 1970s.
Confess your sin to the Lord and he'll blot it out.
Frank Houston was no pioneer for Christianity. His legacy remains a faded memory of a pedophile. Regardless of today's outcome, I have received a life sentence. Blaming the victim is as repulsive as the assaults themselves.
Brian Houston only learned of the crimes when his dad came clean in 1999. He claimed he never went to police because Brett Sengstock told him not to. The victim was paid $10,000, which he believed to be hush money.
I found out that my own father, who I love incidentally, had conducted himself in a manner that was predatory.
Sermons like this seen as proof Houston Jr. wasn't hiding the truth.
As far as I'm concerned, this was a targeted attack. If I wasn't Brian Houston from Hillsong, this charge would never have happened.
Cleared of criminality, but Houston's been ousted by Hillsong for breaching its moral code over inappropriate behaviour towards two women. Just this week, the megachurch celebrated 40 years of faith and its founder was left off the invite list. Would you do it differently today?
Did you make mistakes?
How is your relationship with Hillsong? For Brett Sengstock, today's verdict is shattering. But for the first time in 50 years, a court has acknowledged the evil done by his dead abuser.
It should not be this hard.
Tiffany Genders, Nine News.